This series lost, how do you motivate your players? What do you say to them? What are the key messages ahead of this third test?
I mean, it's a build-up. We have 5 tests remaining for the year. And, you know, test championship points still at stake. We have a lot to play for. And that's my thing to the boys. You know, we still need the test championship running. And, you know, obviously we're looking for points as well.
And as you look to build the test team, it's a young test team. How important that you take something from this series and you keep fighting here?
Yeah, it's very important. I mean, it's all about fighting. And I think once we continue to create that kind of attitude around this test team, there will be growth, and that's what we're after.
Can you put your finger on what hasn't gone right in these two tests? There were obviously chances on day one at Trent Bridge, but what do you think it's not worked?
I think all wrong, we didn't put it together as yet. Obviously we batted well at Trent Bridge, we didn't bat well in the second innings, and we bowled well in pieces. I think collectively, obviously we drop chances would happen, but I think our groupings as a bowling unit weren't as they should. And I think once we get that percentage up, you know, we'll be able to create more chances and at least be able to, you know, stop the flow of runs on both sides of the wicket.
England have named an unchanged team. Do you know your team yet?
Well, Sinclair is out with a fracture. He got the blow he got to with Mark Wood. So Morty's backing. And Akeem Jordan, so we have a 12. We name a 12 because Shamar Joseph just has a bit of flu. So we're waiting on tomorrow morning to make the decision on the 11. So we just have 12 for now.
And have you looked at the pitch yet?
Yeah, I saw it. Looks a good cricket pitch. Looks a good cricket pitch.
Thank you.
Stefan?
Hi, Craig. I was actually going to ask about T, but can I ask, what's the badge that you're wearing?
I'm my grandparents. Yeah.
Any reason?
Yeah, I mean, they're just with me forever. They're not here anymore. They meant a lot for me. Did a lot for me in my life, so, you know, you always have them on my heart every day.
Will? Craig, you mentioned Rockwood's delivery to Sinclair. Fractures, wrist, or whatever. Do that spell at bowling, all those spells at Trent Bridge, was that about as quick as you faced?
It was fast. It was fast for sure. And he, unfortunately, Sinclair got the blow. But yeah.
What does that do when the opposition have got a bowler that fast in their attack? What impact does it have on your whole group?
We focus on all the bowlers. You know, we don't single out anyone. We focus on all the bowlers we have to face.
Sorry, Craig, can I just check? Is the fracture his wrist, or is it just a bit further up on his forearm?
Probably in his forearm. Slit fracture.
Jules?
Yeah. You competed pretty well at Trent Bridge. Was that just a reminder of how one bad hour can, like, really mess up a test match for you or any team?
Yeah, I think For the boys playing, at least it was almost clear to see. I mean, we had a 50-run opening stand, and then from there, you know, we lost 10 wickets quite quickly. And we knew we were in the game. So it goes to show, I think, what you're saying in terms of the always. At least it shows that you got to be on it always, you know, not just for the first 3 days, you know, as soon as you lose that focus. And it could be as a bowling unit or a batting unit, you know. And you lose it for an hour, you could, you know, be behind the test match and lose it. So it was good. We should learn from that. And obviously the learning, you know, for that is just never taking anything for granted. Always having the same attitude, you know, as in first innings, second innings, batting and bowling. And, you know, once we keep that attitude of fighting every session, I think that will serve us well.